Doctor Who. High on a mountainside, in the shelter of a rocky outcrop, a campfire glimmers fitfully in the night air. Edward Travers, awoken by the cry, sits up quickly.
John?
Noticing his companion's empty sleeping bag, Travers takes his rifle and moves towards the sound.
John, where are you?
Travers staggers back, his face contorted with fear. He backs up a few paces, then turns and stumbles away into the night. An enormous shadow falls across the campsite, and an object is tossed to the ground. Travers' rifle, twisted beyond recognition. The Abominable Snowmen, by Mervyn Haisman and Henry Lincoln. Episode 1. Inside the TARDIS, the Doctor, Jamie and Victoria are gathered around the scanner screen.
I don't believe it. Marvellous! After all this time!
Oh, what's so marvellous about that?
But don't you see, Jamie? It's the Himalayas! And I do believe we're in exactly the right... wait a minute.
The Him of what?
Shush!
The Himalayas, Jamie. They're mountains.
I can see that. Hey, is it the Earth Doctor?
I do fancy another tangle down the Cybermen's tomb.
Shush, Jamie. Yes, of course it's the Earth. Yes, I think I'm right. Yes.
Where are these mountains?
Don't you know where the Himalayas are? They're in India. Well, at least I think so.
Yes, that's it! I knew it! It's incredible! Right. Oh, no! No, not India. This is Tibet. That's where we are, Tibet. Now, there's no time to be lost. Come along, Jamie. We must find the Ganta.
The what?
The Ganta. I put it here somewhere. Come along, Jamie, help me.
He begins to rummage in an enormous chest.
Hey, what am I supposed to be looking for?
I told you it's...
Good Lord. Oh, I haven't seen that for years.
Oh, that's the Ganta then.
No. It's, well, whatever it is, it's nice to see it again.
Jamie has found a set of bagpipes.
Thank you. Come along.
Hey, Doctor, would you look at these? You never told me you had these.
No, Jamie.
Hey, oh, I could fix those easily.
Yes, I was afraid of that.
Jamie, you're getting as bad as the Doctor.
Come along. Help me find
them. It would help us considerably if we knew what we were looking for.
Ganta!
But what is it?
Oh, what is it? You don't know.
Oh, it's a bell.
Oh, it's a bell, Jamie.
Oh, a bell. Oh, well, now yes. We know what we're looking for.
Yes, it's a Tibetan bell, actually. A holy relic. This one is quite small. It has a dragon on it. In fact, it has rather an interesting history. It was... Oh. Yes, I'll have that.
He brings out a huge fur coat.
Yes, it's just the thing for this climate. You might as well find yourself something while you're about it. How do I look?
Doctor, you look beautiful.
Yes, I thought I might. I think I'll go and have a scout around. Now, you two find the bell. It's very important.
Oh, but why do you want it?
Because down there, it's going to guarantee us the welcome of a lifetime.
Down there?
Oh, don't ask me. When you've been with a doctor as long as I have, you begin to realize you don't know what he's talking about. Oh, we better find this bell of his.
Oh, wait a minute, Jamie.
Hey, come and give us a hand.
I want to see where the doctor's gone. Now, if I turn this to the left, should... Aha, that's it!
Jamie extracts a large scimitar from the chest.
Hey, now would you look at this? Oh, that's marvellous. What? Hey, what's that?
Where?
A great sort of hairy beastie. Turn the thing back.
Oh.
No, to the right. Downwards. That's it. There.
A large fur-covered figure looms up on the screen.
Oh, no. My mistake. The great hairy beastie. It's the doctor.
Out on the mountainside, tightly wrapped in his oversized fur coat, the doctor clambers over a crest and is afforded a spectacular view of some buildings nestling in the valley below.
Yes. Ah, yes.
In the TARDIS, Jamie has found a drawstring bag labelled Ganta of Detsen Monastery.
Monastery?
Now, that'll be where he's gone.
Wonder why he wouldn't take us.
Well, we can never tell with the doctor. Hey, just thought. The lasses into monasteries.
I don't know. Oh, don't say that.
Oh, never mind. I suppose he'll manage somehow.
Hey, shall we open it?
Oh, I don't think so. The doctor might not like it.
Making his way back to the TARDIS, the doctor notices something on the ground. He bends down to examine a vast footprint. some way off, a shaggy figure watches from behind a tree. As the doctor straightens up, the figure disappears.
Apart from climbing boots, I really think you ought to wear something warm.
I tell you, I'm a Highlander. The cold doesn't affect me.
There's a great deal of difference between the Highlands and the Himalayas, James.
Aye, they're bigger.
Oh, there you are, Doctor. I found this bell thing you were looking for.
Oh, splendid, splendid.
Is the monastery far? Can we come too?
Yes. No. One thing at a time, Victoria. We must find this Gantar.
Oh, here. Is this where we're going? Detsen?
Detsen, yes. That's the name of the monastery, but I'm afraid you're not going. Well, not yet a while, anyway.
Doctor.
No, I think it'd be better if I went alone.
You've seen something, haven't you? Would it not be better if I went with you?
Is there something dangerous then, Doctor?
Oh, good heavens, no! No, there's nothing for you to worry about. Now, you stay here with Janie, inside, and I'll be as quick as I can.
Oh, Doctor.
She holds out the bag.
Oh, I nearly forgot it.
A trail of the huge footprints leads across the rocky terrain and into the trees, where the same large, hairy figure stands staring down onto the path. The doctor approaches. He stops in his tracks and looks questioningly around him. After a few moments' contemplation, he carries on his way. With the contents of the chest now tidied away, Jamie and Victoria are sitting idly on a pair of stools.
Oh, I'm getting bored. Well, let's go outside.
No, I don't think we should.
All right, I'll go by myself.
Oh, no, you won't. You won't leave me here by myself.
Oh, come on, we needn't be long.
Well, just a quick look then.
Continuing on his way down the hillside, the doctor stumbles upon Travers' deserted campsite, where the dying embers of the fire crackle beside two empty sleeping bags.
Anybody here?
Looking around, he discovers the twisted rifle and picks it up to examine it, worriedly. Following some marks scuffed onto the ground, he rounds a rock and finds the body of Travers' companion. A cursory examination confirms that he is dead. Victoria, standing high on a rock, gazing in trance at the view below.
What can you see?
Come on, it's a marvellous view.
Aye, so it is, and I've come away back.
Why?
Because the doctor said that... Well, if you must know, I am cold.
Didn't I tell you? Now, why don't you go and get that coat?
Because I'm not leaving you out here on your own, and that's final.
Jamie, look!
What is it?
Footprints. The size of them. Something's been walking round the TARDIS. What could it be, Jamie? A bear?
Whatever it is, it's pretty big. We'd better get inside.
I'd like to find out what it is first. Wouldn't you?
Look, you must be careful. This could be dangerous. Wait while I get that sword.
They disappear into the TARDIS, where Jamie equips himself with winter coat and weapon. With an air of confidence, the doctor strides up to the large main gate set into the monastery wall. He is carrying Travers's abandoned rucksack.
Hello there!
The doctor tries one last time, then pushes at the smaller wicket gate, which slowly swings open.
Beyond the gate. We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.